a verse in this week's Parsha, Parsha Mishpatim. It says, "Va'asher lo yitzodo, va'lo yikimino liyodo, v'samte lechomokim asher yonos sham." So this is speaking about the city of refuge. If someone, by God forbid, killed somebody by mistake, asher lo yitzodo, he did not plan, he did not wait. There was no, wasn't a premeditated murder.
It just happened.
So he has a place to yanus sham. He has a place to run. It is called Ir Miklat, city of refuge. And Rotzeach Rishkagah, someone who killed somebody mistakenly, there's laws of Goel Adam, the redeemer of the blood. So if a family member catches the murderer, we'll call him a murderer, but he's not, to say, a murderer that planned it.
Right.
Didn't mean it. The relative is allowed to kill him. But if he made it into the city of refuge, according to Torah, he's not allowed to touch him. Okay? So it says, if he did not lie in wait, meaning there was no, he wasn't planning to kill the guy.
No premeditation.
But God caused it to happen to him. For example, he was chopping wood, and it says, "Venashala barzel minayetz," the metal took off, it broke off from the handle, and killed somebody. Right? I will provide you a place to which he can flee. Right? It was Ori Mikla, city of refuge. Allegorically, going against Hashem's will, is a form of murder. Why? For in both cases, the soul is ripped away from its spiritual source of life. Soul is being torn away from its source of life. However, since we are all intrinsically connected to God, it is totally unnatural for us to do anything He would disapprove of. So even someone who sins, it's something that is unnatural to him. Deep inside, he's not comfortable with it. Because his soul does not approve it.
We said it's a moment of folly.
Right. Doing so, right, so that's the title, temporary insanity,
yeah, right?
Doing so is therefore the result of temporary insanity, a sudden, fleeting attack of folly that convinces us that our connection to God will not suffer as a result of improper behavior. So he's thinking that his connection to Hashem remains the same. That's why you hear the sentence, "You think you're better Jews than me? We're all the same Jews, we're all the same thing." Obviously there is ramifications, right? And the connection to Hashem is weakened by every sin that we, God forbid, do. Therefore, God considers the murder unintentional and provides us with a city of refuge. What is the city of refuge? Where we may recover and renew our connection to Him. A place that we can go to and renew the connection to God. The city of refuge is the study of the Torah and the prayers we recite with a sincere and humbled heart. So we can find refuge in the Torah to atone for our sins. Go to page 173. Ve'eila mishpatim, these are the laws that you shall set before them. Moshe Rabbeinu told the Jewish people, God gave you His Torah. If you fail to observe the laws and judgments, God will take it from you. Why? Because He gave you His Torah on condition that you implement its judgment. As it is stated, the might of the king who loves judgment, if you implement its judgments, God will restore your batei dinim, your courthouses. In the future era, as it is stated, I will restore your judges. Hashiva shofteinu karishana, that we say in Shmunas every day. I will restore your judges as at first. Yeshaya 1:26. What is written in the very next verse? Sion will be redeemed through justice. Sion v'mishpat yipadeh v'shaveh v'zdakah. So we see the importance of implementing the laws of Torah. This way, Sion will be redeemed and Mashiach will come. Let's go in Yaakov.
Thank you very much.